Hi, my name is Cedric. I'm product manager here at Grafana Labs. Let me show you what's new in application observability. Oftentimes, when working with application performance data, you're asking yourself the question, is what I'm seeing normal, or is it a deviation from my expectation and thus an anomaly? How can we know? In application observability, we introduced a capability called time window comparison. So now, with a click of a button, you can enable a comparison time frame, and it can either be the previous period, or the week before, or even the month before, and then you can set your current data into context of the historic performance of this particular service. Sometimes an exact comparison is not what you're looking for. That's why we introduced a capability called automatic baselining. An automatic baseline metric is calculated from your historic data, and it uses standard deviation to factor in some seasonality effects and aggregates the previous performance. Let's switch to baseline as comparison time frame here. As you can see, we now have a baseband in the rate panel and all the others. And we can see our current data, which is the green band in the middle, and then the upper and lower boundary denoted by this colorful band, which is the expectation of the performance based on the historic performance of this particular service. Automatic baselines are available for the red metrics, rate, error, and duration for every service in application observability once you configured it. Let's imagine that through one of our comparisons we found an interesting time series, a deviation that we can't really explain, and now we want to use domain-specific attributes to actually find out what's wrong. So we can use group by and filter by to sequentially narrow down until we reduce the noise so much that we get to the actual signal. Okay, in application observability, you can always select a group by dimension. In our configuration, we have enabled metric generation for the geo.country attribute. And now we can enable group by geo.country, and the one time series gets broken down into individual time series, one per dimension in this particular attribute. And we can see that the different countries here, Germany, Poland, Spain, and USA, have different performance. This breakdown enables you to better understand the characteristics of your deployments. Let's see, for example, in the duration panel here, we can see that Spain has a higher latency usually than the other countries. That's interesting. So now we can use filter by to once again select the geo.country attribute, and then we can select the Spain value and reduce the noise in our user interface. And we'll get to the signal. Now we only see the time series for Spain. We can remove the group by dimension and start again with a different attribute that we can then group by and sequentially reduce the noise. Let's imagine that we are close enough and we now really want to investigate some of the errors that we are seeing. So we introduced more contextual navigation. At any given point in time, you could navigate to traces for a given time frame, for example, or to the logs that are related to the service. But you can now natively interact with the graphs here in the rate, error, and duration panels. So, for example, this particular time frame looks interesting to me, and I can now jump to logs for this particular time frame or traces that were just produced within this particular time frame. And you can see that we transferred all the filter attributes into that new user interface here, and you now see at the particular set of transactions that you have already narrowed down through group by and filter by. And this should greatly help you find the transactions that are interesting for you and have the performance characteristics that you were looking for. You can do that from any panel in Application Observability Service Detail Dashboards. So it works for rate, error, and duration. One of the more interesting things for you to get started very quickly is actually the Go to Traces button right here. If you click here in the errors panel, then we show you just the traces that have an erroneous span. So for example, this trace that originated in the load generator, it is marked as erroneous, and we can neatly see the chain in the transaction here. That's a trace that went through load generator, then front end proxy, some envoy middleman here, and then into the front end service. And then the place order gRPC action actually was marked as the root of this error. And if we open the details here, then we can see the error message of the gRPC library unavailable. It seems like the downstream service that was meant to be called by this gRPC interaction was not available. And this is now your place to start investigating why that downstream service wasn't there. We think this in-context navigation for traces and logs really helps you to narrow down more quickly. You can also do it from the duration distribution. So for example, if we look here, we have these buckets, and if you just want to see traces that are in this 25 milliseconds bucket, you can actually click on that and directly zoom in, and you have the relevant filter applied. Imagine that you're seeing very high durations for transactions and it's not really expected. Then here you are, it's very easy for you to just find these transactions that are slow, and then you can drill down into these and find out what's wrong about them. And that's all that I got for you today. Happy observing!